The RSPCA has reacted furiously to disturbing claims South Australian greyhounds have been involved in live baiting. It says dogs have gone interstate to be trained in the barbaric practice, and Greyhound Racing SA is not taking the issue seriously.
When live baiting was exposed in the east, it sickened the community. Now, South Australia's RSPCA boss has revealed Greyhound Racing SA admitted locally bred dogs may also be involved.
They've acknowledged to us that dogs, they believe, have gone from South Australia to the eastern states to be trained using live baiting techniques.
We couldn't rule out the possibility that that's what's occurred, but certainly we can only control what occurs here.
The RSPCA is accusing the racing body of not taking industry reform seriously in the wake of a nationwide crackdown. It says when a Two Wells trainer was busted with drugs earlier this year, Greyhound Racing SA refused to drug test dogs at the property.
I personally asked the GRSA integrity officer and the GRSA CEO to swab and blood test those 60 dogs. They didn't do it.
It wasn't part of our normal protocol. Those drugs, when found on the premises, were the source of the breach of the rule. The rule was about possession.
It's prompted calls for self-regulation to be scrapped and the establishment of an independent authority. The RSPCA says if these reforms don't occur, they'll take the fight even further and demand that the racing industry is shut down.
If there is a sensible response to deal with a problem, we're happy to look at it because we support their objectives.
Sport Minister Leon Bignall agrees but has accused the RSPCA of grandstanding.
And we're not asking for the taxpayer to do anything around this. All of these reforms should be industry funded.
Eddie Godfrey, Nine News.